Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on my channel. You can watch various programming related videos on my channel. So you can search it, you type it. It contains more than 800 videos. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can use command line arguments in Java. So here I am using CMD as name of class. Then I will be implementing main function. Inside main function, I will be writing some instructions. First, see here, in every Java program, you might be using main function. And in these parentheses, you might be using this args array of string type. So this array is used to hold the arguments which are passed through command prompt. If you want to check values of those arguments, then you can print them like this. If you are passing only one argument, then that argument will be stored at 0th index of args array. So it will be printed on output screen through this system.out.println command. So I am saving this code. First, I am executing this small segment of code so that you can understand how we can pass or where we can write that argument. So that it will be received in args array. So first we need to compile the code. After successful compilation, when you are executing the code with Java command, then you have to pass that command line argument. So here I am passing my name as command line argument. You can see the output, argument equals to Sanjay. So 0th index is storing Sanjay as command line argument. If you are passing more than one arguments, then those arguments will be stored at various indexes like 0, 1, 2 and so on. In that case, you can write like this. If you are passing two arguments, you can print args 0 and then args 1. Again, I am going to compile and execute this code. You can see this time it is printing two arguments, my first name and last name. Now, suppose you want to pass n number of arguments whenever you execute this code, then you require a flexible code which can receive two arguments, three, four, and so on. So in that case, you have to use a loop to process this args array. Now see this code segment, I have implemented a loop starting from 0. Here condition is I less than args.length. So in Java, each array contains a particular attribute named as length, which provides size of the array. So if you are passing 3 arguments, this loop will repeat 3 times. If you are passing 5 arguments, this loop will repeat 5 times. And then args of I will be printing arguments on output screen. So this code can receive any number of arguments whenever it will be executed. Now we have to compile and execute this code so that we can test it. This time I will be passing names of different countries. So first time I am passing names of 3 countries. You can see the output. It is showing all the names properly. Now, see it carefully. I am not compiling the code. I am just executing it without making any change in the code. I am adding some more names of countries. This time I am passing 5 country names as command line arguments. So it is processing all those names properly. So this way, I hope you have understood how we can receive command line arguments in main method, how we can process them, whether they are in one quantity, two quantity, or n number of quantities. So this way, I hope you have understood why args string array is available in main method. I hope you have understood it well. If you want to follow me, you can subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.